Now, this is specially catered for all of you who are in a sales profession, possibly working for an organization or working for yourself. One thing that people have always asked me really is this: how is it that some people are having an extraordinary sales career and some people are struggling all the time? Some people have always said, is it really about the market rising and that's why we are able to keep up? But have you ever met before salespeople who are able to rise with the market? And even when the market goes down, they still remain on top. And then there are those whereby what happens very simply is that when the market goes up, they go up. When the market goes down, they go down. A lot of people have always told me, Leroy, isn't it really about sales techniques? Isn't it really about all the kind of techniques that you have at your fingertips that you can really use to convince people? It is. However, at the same time, it starts from somewhere else. It starts from the psychology. So what I'm going to share with you right now is going to blow your mind. It's going to make you look at things from a very different perspective from now on. If we were to take a look at sales, many of us are very result-oriented, aren't we? We think about our quotas, we think about our targets, we think about all the different types of, you know, benchmarks that we have to hit. We've got to hit this target, we've got to hit that target. Our managers give us this amount of sales to hit. They tell us that we have to always continuously hit the target or break it. And because of that, we have ultimately become people who are very result-oriented. That we determine how good we really are based on the results that we have in our sales. So what happens here is this. Based on our past results, we tend to begin to form beliefs about whether or not we are a good salesperson or whether or not we are bad. I'll give you an example. If let's say in 1 month, you have a good sales, what happens is that it reinforces the belief that, you know what, I'm a good salesperson. And the very next month, it becomes a bad sales month. What happens after that is that you begin to question yourself and you say, maybe I'm not so good after all. And then the very next month, it becomes a bad month again. And then you go, you know what, I'm definitely not a good salesperson. And then the following month, you had quite a number of sales. You hit your targets, you smashed the targets, and you went, maybe I'm doing something right now. And then after a while again, the sales goes down again. And then you begin to change the beliefs. So ultimately, what happens is that your results are always determining the beliefs that you have about yourself. So some salespeople, this is what happens, all right? The results are negative. So they form a very negative belief about themselves. Some people, when the results become positive the next month or the next week, they say, you know what, now I'm a pretty good salesperson. And then the very next week, it goes wrong again. And so they've got a negative belief about themselves. And this keeps on changing over and over again. So this residual effect of past results are helping this person to determine how good they are for tomorrow. Now, is it healthy in a sales career? Not really. Why? Because if your results are good, you feel good. If your results are bad, you feel bad. When your results are good, you feel good. If your results are bad, you feel bad. So this ultimately creates what? Frustration. Because you're not really sure whether, am I good in sales or am I not good in sales? And some of us, we tend to say, well, maybe it's really about the customer. Maybe it's really about the quality of my product. And we begin to go around in circles, begin to feel horrible about what's going on. Let me share with you how extraordinary salespeople do it, all right? Let's go. Now, extraordinary salespeople, they are also result-oriented. However, they begin with this one thing that we call their beliefs. They have an extraordinary mindset, a mindset that says, I believe I'm a great salesperson. I'm a great salesperson. I can go out there and I can persuade. I can go out down there and I can begin to sell. So with this extraordinary mindset, they know one thing. I'm as capable as every other salesperson out there. The only question is, am I willing to tap into my potential? Am I willing to take action? What do I mean by that? We've always said that if we choose to believe positively about ourselves, we tend to tap into our potential. Now, what is really interesting about potential here is this. Some people, they try to tap into their potential by looking at why their product is not selling, and then they try to figure out why it's not selling. Some of them, they look at the customers and they ask themselves, why is my customer not buying? And what happens very simply is that they go into this whole situation whereby they start to complain, they start to justify, they start to make excuses. You are tapping into your potential, but you're tapping into the wrong potential. Now, what you need to do is to begin to change your whole ideology of what potential really is about. It's always about tapping into what I like to call positive potential. Because when you tap into positive potential, what you're ultimately doing is that you're bringing out a lot of strategies. So what they do is that they go out down there and they begin to find new ways of doing things. They identify for themselves. How do I sell better? How do I convince better? How do I persuade better? So when this happens, they go out and they begin to sell, right? And what happens is that they get their results. Now, if the result is positive, fantastic, because it reinforces the belief that I'm good, right? If the result is negative, what they ultimately do is this, is that they do not change their belief. They remain constant to their belief. They still say, look, I am still persuasive. I'm still convincing. I'm still able to go out there and make great sales. The only question is my strategy. Let me give you an example. This person, if they remain in a result-oriented mode to decide their belief system, if let's say, for example, they get a phone call, the client says no, they put on the phone and they go into a very negative cycle. What they do is this, they say, what went wrong? Why is my client not buying? What is it about my product that doesn't seem to sell? And they start to go in this cycle of wondering what went wrong and what went wrong and what went wrong. What does this create? Frustration. It creates frustration because the very next month they sell. And when they sell, they say, you know what? Maybe I did something right today. Or some of you might even have said that before. This month, I am lucky. Ask yourself, have you ever asked that question before? Have you ever told yourself that before? Is this the month that I'm lucky? So what this creates is this, am I good? Am I not so good? Am I good? Am I not so good? So you get this little inner battle that goes on, right? And it comes to a point whereby you get frustrated. So you think, should I leave this industry or change company? Or some of us have this belief that maybe if I change my product and I sold something else, I'll be a lot better. I give you example number two. These people have an extraordinary belief. They believe that everything can be sold and a great salesman is able to sell everything. And is that true? Definitely. Because what happens if a client calls up and they say, no, they're not interested, when they put the phone down, they say what? They say this. How can I bring this sale back? And if let's say, for example, the sale cannot be brought back, they will ask themselves that question. How can I improve on my next sales call? How can I improve on my next sales appointment? How can I use this as a learning experience to help me to be able to go out there and be a lot more convincing? So ultimately, what they do is that they are always on the search for skills and techniques. And my friends, that is where skills and techniques come in. When you need to go and find out how to be more persuasive, how to be more convincing, how to be more, you know, convicting in whatever it is that you are saying to them. And I'm very sure that right now, you have found that this session is extremely beneficial to you because you have now realized for yourself that having the extraordinary mindset is first and skills and techniques come second.